chase me.
And when I began to put pen to paper and began to look at
amen, all of my bad days, yeah, and all of my good days. I think the song said all of my good days outweigh. Come on, somebody. My bad days. Is that right? Amen. And so we're thanking the Lord today. Praise God that He is good. So we worship God through the fruit of our lips. But we extend our worship. Amen. If you worship God with the substance of our hands.
Amen.
Amen. So prepare your hearts to honor the Lord. Amen. As we bless Him because He has blessed us.
Amen.
Amen. How many know that God is able to give you what money cannot buy?
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. My God.
You can't write a big enough check to get peace of mind.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. The Federal Reserve does not have enough money.
All right.
To give you the kind of joy that the Lord can give. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Amen. Some of my best days that were full of joy when I didn't have a dime in my pocket. Come on, somebody. But when I thought of the goodness of Jesus, all that He's done for me. Hallelujah, I began to hear doorbells. Oh, y'all know a thing about doorbells? Hallelujah. Didn't have money to pay a bill. But when I thought of the goodness of Jesus, hallelujah, doorbells start ringing in my soul. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, bless His name. Hallelujah. Praise God. So get ready to honor the Lord today as we worship God through giving, through giving, through giving, through giving. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen. God bless you, Bishop. Thank you, Lord.
Come on, let everybody say amen.
Amen.
Come on, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We ask everyone, if you have your seat prepared to stand all over the building as we pray together. Amen. Come on, I ought to tell you, you ought to be excited about your giving. Hallelujah. You ought to be excited to give. Being that God is so gracious that He blesses to be here.
Amen.
And He keeps on blessing.
Amen.
Keep on blessing. Hallelujah. With seed in hand, let us all bow in prayer. Father God in heaven, we thank You, Lord.
Thank You.
For gracing us once more with life. We thank You for everyone that are here, Father. That You continue to bless us, Father, to go forward for Your glory. Father, we ask that You touch everyone here today as they stand in obedience and they give in. With seed in hand, Father, we ask that You bless them, multiply 30, 60, 100-fold blessings upon their lives. Father, we believe that the body shall receive increase. Let the body say increase.
Increase.
Come on, say it like you mean it, increase.
Increase.
Father, we know that You are God that can meet all needs. And Father, we ask that You meet every need that needs to be met. Father, keep Your hand and Your love upon everyone here, that they may continue to go forward for Your glory. Father, for it is in Your darling Son Jesus' name, we thank You as we give, so that we give freely, Father, that You have so given freely to us life and blessings. We thank You, Jesus. We thank You. In Jesus' name, let the body say, thank You, Lord.
Thank You, Lord.
Thank You, Lord.
Thank You, Lord.
Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Starting from the rear rows, we'll ask that you are turning facing the walls, making your way to the front. The ushers are coming forward to receive your giving. May God bless you and may God keep you.
Lord, hallelujah. I know You've been so good. Thank you.
wonderful that we can declare and decree that the Lord has been good. He is good. And always will be good. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the name of our God. So we thank you, praise God. We thank God for you that are here. We are delighted to have you in the house of the Lord today. Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
Let us make a few observations before we get into the word today. We want to also to remind you again that out in the foyer, praise God, we have boxes of cards, of invitation cards. We ask that you would get some of these cards and make these accessible to friends and family and neighbors and co-workers. Invite them to church. Amen.
Amen.
And on the back, there is our service time on the back of the card. So freely pick up some of those cards. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. Hallelujah. And encourage someone to come to the house of prayer.
Amen.
Praise God. You'd be surprised of people. Sometimes they're just waiting on an invite.
Amen.
Amen. They're waiting for somebody to think of them enough to invite them to come to the house of prayer. Amen.
Amen.
So they're there, amen, out there in the foyer for your access, so you'll be able to have something in hand to share with people concerning your church.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise God. So we thank God for you that are here today. Praise God. Hallelujah. We are streaming live. Amen. As of today, we're streaming live. Praise God through Ustream. And we're going to give you information later where you can access that and see the broadcast. So our broadcasts are going live as we speak. And so we're excited about that. And so I can tell you this. If you tune in to Ustream, praise God, you would go to B-O-H-C-TV. B-O-H-C-TV. All capital letters. Amen. And you can tune in and you can let your neighbors and friends and families, amen, around the world to tune in to a live streaming broadcast. And so right now, praise God, we invite those that are tuned in, amen, that are listening to Bread of Heaven Church broadcast on Little Rock, Arkansas. And we're excited and we encourage all of those that are viewing to tune in. Praise God. Check us out on Facebook, Instagram, amen, Twitter. Praise God. And we welcome all of our viewing audience. That is B-O-H-C-TV. Amen. All capital letters. You can stream and you can watch when you're on vacation, when you're away.
Amen.
Amen. You can tune in and we are live as we speak. Amen.
Amen.
So we thank God for those different platforms that we have access to. And it's our endeavor to get the word out any way we can.
Amen.
And to expose Jesus to the world.
Amen.
Amen. In any medium that we have access to. And so we thank God for that. Amen. Praise God. And as we said, that I am needing a social media, praise God, coordinator. And we made mention of that last week. If you into Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and all of that, I need you. Amen. I can do a little something, but I don't have the time to do it justice. Amen. So if you're in that, I need you to help, amen, promote the gospel, promote the ministry, amen, through those different social platforms. And so we're excited about that. We also are needing someone to help us man, amen, the camera as we stream and as we record our services. If you want to be a part of that ministry, your services are needed as well. Amen?
Amen.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Well, let's get into the word. We thank God for all of you. Amen. Good to see some familiar faces back with us again.
Amen.
Praise God. You lighten my heart. Praise God. You bring a smile on my face to see you.
Amen.
Praise God. You are definitely in my prayers. And so when I see your face, praise God,
amen,
I know that God is yet blessing.
Amen.
Well, don't know what's wrong with my eyes, but my eyes are getting bleary for some reason. Amen. So I'm going to try to do what best I can here this morning. Pray for me. Pray for me. Let's go to St. John chapter 13. St. John chapter 13. We want to look at some scriptures here. I'm excited about what the Lord is doing and what God is getting ready to do. Amen. We are in an exciting time of our life.
Amen.
And so we give God praise to these elders, these ministers, these men and women of God that are connected to this house. We thank God for your service. St. John chapter 1, and let's begin to look at verse 1, 2, and 3, and then verse 11, and then verse 21 through 27. St. John the 13th chapter, verse 1, 2, and 3, verse 11, verse 21 through 27. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let's read. The Bible said, now before the feast of the Passover, when Jesus knew that his hour was come, that he should depart out of this world unto his Father, having loved his own which were in the world, he loved them unto the end. And supper being ended, the devil having now put into the heart of Judas Iscariot, Simon's son, to betray him. Verse 11 says this. Verse 11, for he knew who should betray him. Therefore said he, ye are not all clean.
Amen.
Verse 21 through 27. When Jesus had thus said, he was troubled in spirit and testified and said, verily, verily, I say unto you, that one of you shall betray me. Then the disciples looked one on the other, doubting of whom he spake.
Mm-hmm.
Now there were leaning on Jesus' bosom one of his disciples whom Jesus loved. Simon Peter therefore beckoned to him that he should ask, who is it? Or who it should be of whom he spake. He then lying on Jesus' breast, said unto him, Lord, who is it? Jesus answered, He it is to whom I shall give a sop when I have dipped it. And when he had dipped the sop, he gave it to Judas Iscariot, the son of Simon. And after the sop, Satan entered into him. Then said Jesus unto him, that thou do quickly. Amen?
Amen.
You may be seated. I want to talk briefly. Amen. Again, I say it's good to see you today. Amen. I want to talk briefly, not long today. I want to talk about I need Judas.
All right.
I need Judas.
All right.
Amen.
All right,
yeah. That is something that most folks would not own up to. Most folks would not even dare to consider this type of person involved in their life. But I need Judas, amen? Matter of fact, amen, be bold enough to look at your neighbor and tell him, I need Judas. Amen. You didn't say it like you really meant it. I need Judas. Amen. And we're going to understand better by and by. But our lesson indicates to us as we look at our lesson, the scenes leading up to the crucifixion of Christ. Amen. Of how God was orchestrating the final hours of the life of Christ.
Yes, sir.
Amen. And if we look at the life of Jesus leading up to the cross, amen, he went to a garden. And the garden was called Gethsemane. It was a place of pressing. And, amen, we find there that Jesus had a struggle. Amen, amen. The Mary side of him did not want to die. Amen. Is that right?
Yes.
Yeah. Amen. But the God side of him is able to say, nevertheless, thy will be done. Is that right?
Amen.
All of us have those struggles, and all of us have those battles within ourselves, whether to do right and whether to do wrong and whether to submit and whether to reject. And we all have those inward struggles in our lives. Man, it's common, it's natural, it's human.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Man, you're in good company.
That's right.
Because Jesus wrestled. Mm-hmm. Jesus struggled with the decision to lay down his life.
That's right.
Amen. Yeah. Amen. I'm not mad at you. I'm not disappointed with you, because all of us wrestle with conflict and decision and confrontation. All of us, amen. It's not easy, amen, to give yourself to suffering. It's not easy to give yourself to ridicule. It's not easy to give yourself to being rejected and, amen, criticized and ostracized and, amen, thrown into the world and to the wind and to the wilderness. But Jesus gave himself. And there are times in our life that where we must come to the crossroads.
Yes,
sir. Either it's going to be, Lord, thy will be done, or Lord, tell me.
All right.
Yes.
Amen. And there are times in our life that where we will have to succumb to the fact that everything that you encounter in life is not going to be easy.
Yes.
Right. Amen.
Amen. And many of a songwriter and song lyrics have been coined, amen, that there are going to be some dark days.
Uh-huh.
There are going to be some difficult days.
Yeah.
Man. And there are going to be some lonely days.
Uh-huh. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes, Lord.
But those are times where we have to draw on the strength of who he is.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Amen. There are times in your life that where you got to forego what you know.
Right.
Come on, and stand on the word.
Yes.
Amen. You got to forego your ability and your intellect and your schooling. Amen. Isn't it amazing how you can go to school and get all type of degrees and masteries and amen, but yet a lot of those will not, amen, would not prepare you for life.
Yes.
I'm talking about showing up life, real life.
Yes.
Come on, down to the road life. Amen, amen, amen. I may know calculus. I may know, amen, trig. I may know, amen, all of those type of, amen, mechanical and theology, amen, and technological, amen, answers. But there are times where you cannot find the answer, amen, in the book of trig. Come on, you got to go to another book.
All right.
Is that right?
Amen.
To find answers to life.
Amen.
Jesus struggles. He struggles here. But yet he succumbs. Amen. And what's happening in this chapter, amen, was not a surprise to Jesus. Amen. He did not hide. He did not run away from it. Amen. He not only knows what Judas is going to do.
All right.
Amen. But what affects my mind to a degree is that the fact that not only did he know what Judas was going to do, but Jesus authorized it.
Yeah. That's right.
That doesn't set well with my reason and logic the fact that, amen, I know what you're about to do, and I give you the go ahead.
All right.
Come on, somebody. Amen. I see you with the knife in your hand.
Yeah.
But I said, have it. I can't wrap my mind around that. Amen. Because, amen, the natural part of us, we want to do everything we can.
Yes, sir.
Say that. Amen. To destroy that plan.
Yes, Lord.
But Jesus authorized it. Here. Amen. Look what he said. Amen. Jesus authorized it. Because Jesus has always, amen, been a man of purpose and order.
Mm-hmm.
Is that right?
Amen.
Amen. From 12 years of old. Amen. 12 years of age. Amen. Jesus was a man of purpose.
Amen.
Yes.
He was a, amen. He was a man of honor. Amen. And so he understood from 12 years old to the cross that, amen, it always been about kingdom business.
Yes, yes.
That's it. When it came to Jesus, Jesus was always about kingdom business. And so Jesus understands that this is the will of the Father.
Amen.
Yes.
Y'all, sometimes you got to understand that what happened to you, amen, it just didn't just automatically happen, but it was orchestrated by God.
Yes, sir.
Right? Amen. Everything that you would encounter in your life, praise God, God has his hands on it.
Yes, amen.
Amen. And when you look at it, it may look like it's the devil. But how many know that, amen, that, amen, you can't blame the devil for everything.
Come on, man.
Amen. The devil gets blamed for a lot of stuff.
Amen.
That he had nothing to do with. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me. But it was God that orchestrated. Amen. It was God that caused you to, amen, to encounter so and so. Amen. It was God. It was all part of the purpose and order of God.
Amen. Amen.
Jesus understands that this is the will of the Father. Amen. Amen. How many know, amen, that the Father's will be done? Amen.
Yes, sir.
Amen. And I don't care how you try to avoid it. I don't care how you try to, amen, derail, detour, amen, distract the plan of God. Amen. God's will be done.
Amen. Yes, sir.
Amen. And I don't care how much you fast, how much you pray, how much you holler, how much you jump and shout, amen. God is not going to remove everything out of your life.
Right.
There are some things and some people and some circumstances and some situations, amen, and some occurrences that are attached to your destiny.
Yes.
Amen.
You got to go through it.
Yes.
You got to encounter it.
Yes.
Amen. You can't fast this all. Amen. Amen. You ain't fasting. You just, amen, going on a 3-day diet. Amen. God, it's going to happen. It's going to happen. It's going to happen. If it's the will of God, it's going to happen.
Yes, sir.
Right. Amen. Save yourself some, amen, trouble. Go ahead and enjoy this good meal. Come on. Save yourself some sleep. Amen. Stop playing up and down. Amen. It's going to happen. God's will be done. Be done, and Jesus succumbs to that.
Yes, Lord.
Jesus understands that. But it does not negate the fact that he's still human.
That's right.
After all, nobody, something is wrong with you if you enjoy suffering. Something is off. Something is missing. Something. Amen. If you enjoy pain, if you enjoy being cut on, if you enjoy bleeding, if you enjoy, amen, getting your flesh ripped from your body, if you enjoy that, something is wrong. And so Jesus battles with that, but yet he succumbs to the will of the Father.
Amen.
In Matthew's gospel, amen, we can see that Jesus is selecting Judas.
Yes. Well, yes, sir.
He's selecting Judas, and Judas is surprised.
Yeah.
The Bible said over in Matthew 26 and verse 25, Jesus selects him and identifies him. Amen. Judas is found in, amen, in Matthew's gospel. He's found saying, surely not I.
Yeah.
Come on.
All right,
come on, Jesus. Surely not I. Come on, Jesus. You got to be kidding. Not me.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody. I'm one of your trusted folks.
All right.
After all, I'm the treasurer.
All right. Yeah.
Come on, somebody. Amen. Amen. Isn't the one that you can trust the most is the one you can, amen, let you keep your money?
Yeah.
All right.
All
right.
Come on. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing. Come on, somebody. And here Jesus said, yes, it's you. You're the one. You're the one. You're the one. You're the one. Judas just said, Lord, Lord, you don't allow Rabbi. He get all spiritual now. Rabbi. Surely it's not me. Jesus said, yes, it is you. Now, I want you to understand, don't dismiss the reality that Judas is needed.
All right.
Don't dismiss. He's needed. He's needed. And matter of fact, amen. Don't dismiss the reality that that Judas is in your group. Don't dismiss the fact that Judas may be in your group, may be in your clique, Judas may be in your family, and matter of fact, amen, Judas might be in this church. Y'all, hold on. Amen. Don't look at nobody. Look straight. Amen. Look at me. Look at me. Don't look at nobody. Don't look at my God. Don't look at nobody. My God. My wife, look around. Don't look at nobody. I guarantee you, there's a Judas in every family, every clique, every group, and every church. I need him. Judas serves a purpose.
Yeah.
I need him. Nah. Jesus recognized that, but the other boy, they said, no, because he was on occasion that after they finally began to realize, amen, what was going on, one of the disciples said, Lord, do we have enough swords with us? And then began to take him, come on, come on. In other words, Lord, do we need to be packing? Can I bring it to our turn? That's what the word said. Amen. They said, do we have enough swords with us? Because they began to understand something about to go down.
Yeah.
And somebody began to think every Thursday, we have two. Jesus said, that's enough. That's enough. Because we find here that one of them is used in the garden when they came to get Jesus. And then one of the brothers, one of the sanctified brothers, the saved brothers, come on, somebody. Cut off somebody's
ear.
Is that right? Is that what it says? Jesus is gently picked him back up. Is that right? That's what the word says. And so Jesus is not. He wants us to understand, beloved, that Judas is needed. But we also must understand, beloved, the context of the fact of Satan's involvement. Amen. Look what it says in verse 2. Amen. Verse 2 says this, amen. And the supper being ended, the devil having now put into the heart of Judas Iscariot. Amen. Satan comes, and Satan will put into the heart of man deceit. Come on. Trickery.
Yes.
Devices.
Uh-huh.
He puts into the heart of man desires.
Amen.
So we have to understand that Satan has a role in the plan of God.
Amen.
Is that right? Amen. Look at verse 27. Amen. Look at the meat of our verse. Amen. Look at verse 27. Verse 27 says, hallelujah, it says in verse 27 of our lesson, how that God will use the devil. The Bible said, and after the sup, Satan entered into him. Is that right?
Amen.
Entered into him. See, we must understand, amen, the meaning of Satan and Satan's role. Amen. Don't get it wrong. Satan is not some great challenger to God.
That's right.
I don't care what you heard. I don't care what you read. Amen. Satan is no challenge to God.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Thank the Lord.
Hallelujah. God knows all.
Yes, sir.
God sees all.
Yes.
God has all power.
Yes.
All things belong to him.
Yes.
Is that right? So Satan is not a challenge to God. So, amen, stop trying to put Satan on God's level.
Come on.
God has no equal.
Yes.
Y'all don't want to talk to me.
Yes.
God has no challenges.
Yes.
God doesn't lay awake at night thinking about Satan.
Yes.
Huh? Come on, somebody. And matter of is sweet.
Come on.
Is that right? And matter of fact, when I can't find any way in here where God says, ever says, I'm a failure.
All right, now, come on.
Huh? Come on now.
All right.
Satan is no challenge to God.
That's right.
Satan is not a match for my God.
All right now.
God uses Satan to allow him some leeway.
Well,
is that right?
Yes.
Satan has to get permission to even to come against you.
Yes, my God.
Amen. Satan doesn't have all power. No. Satan is not omnipresent.
Right.
He's not everywhere at the same time.
Right. Come on,
somebody.
Come on.
Hallelujah. Yeah. Satan does not know all.
Uh-huh. Right. Come on now.
Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. He doesn't know your next move. He doesn't know, amen, what God is going to do in your life.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. But many times, Satan is lurking about, looking for opportunities.
Well,
looking for weaknesses. Looking for open doors. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Amen. Tell somebody, close your door. Close your door. Close your door and lock your windows. Come on, somebody. Amen. Don't leave a window crack. Don't leave a door ajar. Because Satan will take advantage of the opportunity. And he'll slide in unaware. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. That's why Paul came into the revelation that he said that when good is present, evil is always close by.
That's right.
Is that right?
That's right.
Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. You seen the little, amen, the little commercials, the little cartoons, amen. On the right, my right shoulder, there's an angel. On the left shoulder, there's a devil.
Yeah.
Satan is looking for opportunity. He is an opportunist. Amen. Don't fool yourself. Satan, the Bible says, look at verse 27. The Bible says Satan entered in.
Well,
what does that tell me? That tells me, amen. That tells me, beloved, that you can be called, but he can come in.
Yes. All right.
Come on, talk to me.
Yes.
You can be chosen, but he can come in.
Yes.
Huh? You can be anointed, but he can come in.
Well, yes, sir.
Come on, somebody. If he is the doctor, all you got to do is open the door. He'll come in. He'll come in. He'll come in. He'll come in. And so we have to understand that Satan entered into Judas.
Uh-huh.
But it's all part of God's plan.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Don't panic. Don't panic. Don't panic. Amen. Don't get fearful. Don't get fearful. Don't get fearful when folk all of a sudden turn on you.
Come on.
Amen. You thought they were your bestest friend.
Huh.
Yeah.
Come on.
Come on.
Amen. You thought y'all was bad.
Yeah.
You thought they were your BFF, whatever that means.
Yeah.
Amen. You thought they were your best friend forever.
Huh?
Well,
come on.
But all of a sudden, one moment, Satan entered in.
Come on.
Come on now. Have you gone through that journey?
Yeah.
Where you thought everything was cool?
Yeah.
And everything was on the up and up? And amen, y'all was like that?
Yeah.
Y'all were like that?
Uh-huh.
Come on, somebody. But now y'all like this?
Uh-huh.
What happened? Something happened that where the enemy came in. And then, what it was a lie, a false accusation, gossip. He comes in. Amen. So what this is telling me, that you've got to watch your desires.
Well,
you got to watch your heart. Because if your heart is not right, Satan can and will come in.
Yes.
Is that right?
Right,
sir. Satan come in. Amen. Satan has come into the best of us.
Right.
Is that right?
That's right.
Amen. Let me go to the top of the list. Amen. David, one day, amen, was out for midnight, strolling his garden. He goes to the rooftop and he begins to look at the stars. He said, isn't that wonderful? Isn't that beautiful? And all of a sudden, his eyes gaze across the rooftop. And then he sees a beautiful black woman. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing. She was a beautiful black woman. Amen. And he sees, and he gazes at her. Amen. And he looked too long.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
He looked, and amen. And out of a glance, desire came in. Satan came in. Y'all know the rest of the story. Amen. That this man, King David.
Uh-huh.
I'm talking about Goliath David.
Uh-huh.
I'm talking about David, the apples of God's eye. Amen.
Yeah.
I'm talking about David, the man after God's own heart. But yet, David opened the door and Satan came in.
Uh-huh.
And y'all know the story that not only did he take a man's wife, but he lays with her. She proceeds to become impregnated by him, and now he got to do something. And so therefore, amen, he began to inquire about this woman's husband, and now he said, amen, bring him off the battlefield and let him go home and amen and have some time with his wife. Come on, somebody, amen. When desire comes in and the devil comes in, amen, you begin to start plotting and scheming and planning. A conspiracy. Come on, somebody. And so David began to, amen, he began to plot and plan against this man. And this man was loyal to David. He's no, I can't go home. Amen. We're in the middle of a battle. David said, now I got to think about plan B. And so now plan B. If I can't get him to go home, put him in the heat of the battle.
Come on. All right.
Now come on now.
Can you see how the wrong desire can get you in trouble? Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes, it will.
Wrong desire.
Glory God.
And sometimes it's not your intent.
Right.
Amen. Many times you don't go looking to fall into the creek.
Right.
Well, come on now. Who said that? You don't say, wake up, I think I'm going to fall into the creek today.
Yeah.
No. But if you dangle around the banks too long,
come on now.
You're subject to fall into the creek. I don't go looking for a creek. But if you don't be careful, a creek will find you.
Uh-huh.
And before long, you've given over to desires.
Mm-hmm.
That right in David gave it to desires. Y'all know the story that this man dies.
Yes, he did.
Right.
Now David takes this woman as his own.
Mm-hmm.
That right? She's with child and takes her as her own. But how many know that it does not matter what you can see? God will not allow us to get away with it.
Come on now.
If you're a child of God, you can't get away with it.
That's right.
I don't care what you do. You can't get away with it. Amen.
Well, that's right.
Amen. I shared the story. Amen. I ain't nothing to hide. I shared the story. Amen. Praise God. This pretty. Amen. Beautiful young lady. She called and she wanted prayer. She came to our service one time. I shared this story many times. And beautiful, Halle Berry looking.
All right.
I can't tell too. I'm going to help you. I've been married for over 30 years. I love my wife then. Come on, somebody. But there's some beautiful women out there. Just like she sees some handsome men.
All right.
I ain't even tell my baby. That she got me on the talk. But I wasn't intimidated by her. Because I'm comfortable in my own skin. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me. Y'all ain't gonna say no to me. Amen. But this woman was pretty. She came to our church and God gave me a word for her. And she was so intrigued that she said, Pastor, I need to get with you. Amen. I need to share some things with you about what I've been through. And me, amen, not even thinking about anything. I said, yes. I said, yes, give me a call. Give me a call. And this woman calls me and she said, are you at church? I said, yes, I'm at church. She said, can I come by? on my lunch break. I said, sure. And after I hung up the phone, it hit me. I said, oh, Lord, I'm up here by myself. And this woman is coming up here, and I got a nose and navel. She was a good woman, but she was nosy. Because anytime she see me up here, she'd get in her car and zoom up here. Reverend, I see somebody pop. Reverend. I was like, oh, Lord, Miss Nancy is going to see me up here. I'm by myself with this woman. And I tried to call her right back. See how the devil worked? I couldn't get it. I just hung up with the woman. But I couldn't get on the phone, mama.
All right.
Mama knows she's been up here. Here I am nervous. I said, Lord, get me out of this. I'm you know, and my intent is to do nothing unnothing.
That's right.
But to pray for this woman.
Yeah.
But the devil will get in it. Amen. How many know that he can take what's good and he'll pervert it and distort it to where it looks all wrong?
Right.
Amen. And so amen. She came and I prayed with her. I prayed quick. I prayed with her. Amen. I said, Lord, I'll never do that again. Amen. Because you have to understand. It doesn't matter how saved you are. All it takes is one sleep.
That's right.
That's it.
That's right.
Because you got to deal with the human side of you. You got to deal with the flesh man inside of you. Come on, somebody. And you got to understand that Satan knows how to play our desire.
Right.
That's right.
Amen. And so therefore you got to understand that here. And don't be so hard on Jews.
That's right.
Don't be hard on Jews.
That's right.
Amen. Don't be hard on him, because amen. Many folk have got caught up into selfish desires.
Right.
Mm. Amen. And here Judas is caught up into selfish gain.
Yeah.
The Bible said that Judas began to realize, amen, what he might gain out of betraying Jesus.
Mm.
Money.
Yeah.
Is that right? Mm. Money. Money has turned me.
Yes, sir. Amen.
Is that right?
Amen.
Amen. For the love of money. Some people gotta have.
That's right.
For the love of money, some people really need.
Right.
Amen. Do things, good things, bad things. For the love of money. That's right. For the love of money. Amen. He has a weak moment, and Satan comes in and captures and captivates his heart.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. Judas is looking at the fact that he can gain the money, amen, in his pocket. And so therefore, Satan comes in, because Satan knows our weaknesses.
That's right.
He knows our weaknesses. You may not have a problem with women, men, but you may have a problem with money.
Mm-hmm.
So he can't tempt you with a woman.
Right.
But he'll tempt you with a dog.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Come on, somebody. Mm-hmm. Vice versa. Amen. You may not have a problem with handling money.
Mm-hmm.
But you don't know how to control yourself around women.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. Come on.
All right now.
Come on. Ladies, you may not have a problem.
Yeah.
Amen. You may not have a problem in certain areas. Amen. But your thing is that you can't stay out of the shop.
All right now.
Because when you pass the shop, amen, we got to take care of the Lord's business here. And so we have to understand that Satan knows our weakness, and amen, and he knows how to, amen, how to play on our desire. Our desires. Hallelujah. But I want you to understand that as you begin to look at the context of our lesson, Jesus is telling me that I need Judas.
Yes.
I need him. I need him. I need him. I need him so bad that Jesus said, I can't wait. I can't wait. He said, after the supper had ended, amen. And he took the last piece of biscuit and he began to wipe the bowl, amen, with the last gravy. And he reached over and gave it. Come on, somebody. He gave the last bite to the one who's getting ready to kill. Come on, somebody. Amen. He gave the last piece to the one that's getting ready to turn him in. Come on, somebody. And the Bible says that Jesus, and when Jesus is such a matter of purpose and order, he tells Judas, whatever you got to do, do it. Your destiny. I need you to fulfill your role in my plan. So Judas is needed. Amen. Y'all stop trying to pray Judas away from y'all.
All right now. Come on. Said that.
Judas is doing his job.
Yeah.
By virtue of the fact that you praying to get Judas away, let you know that Judas is working.
Yeah. All right now. Come on down.
By virtue of the fact that you praying, let me know that Judas, my God, he's a good, amen, he's a good worker. By you praying and seeking God to get rid of Judas, come on, Judas is doing what he's been assigned. That's why Paul said, Lord, remove this from me. Hallelujah. Paul said, I prayed three times, but God wouldn't take it away. God just told me, I'm going to send grace. Y'all trying to get rid of Judas.
Yes.
What you ought to be praying, Lord, send grace. But you need Judas. You need Judas. Judas is doing what he's orchestrated to do.
Well,
come on, somebody. See, because you have to understand the order of God, God uses Satan. Mm-hmm. Satan uses people to fulfill the plan of God. Come on, somebody.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. Don't get it twisted. Don't think that Satan has an inside track to what God is doing. Because the Bible said, if he had known,
that's the word,
what was about to go down, he would have stopped the crucifixion. If he had known, but he had no knowledge. Hey. Come on, God used him, and that's why you got to leave Judas alone. See, that's why Jesus, amen, gave the parable. He said, leave the cow alone.
Come on, yes.
Let him grow with the wheat.
Come on.
And at the end of the day. Come on, in that great separation. Come on, I'll divide.
Yeah.
But leave the terror on. You need Judas. You may not know it right now. But you understand it better by and by. That as you mature in God, you begin to understand why you had to go through that. Why you had to put up with it. Why you had to endure folks that everybody else ain't got time to fool with. That you understand why you had to encounter some situations in your life that almost broke you. But they didn't break you, but they made you. Come on, somebody. They didn't destroy you, but they developed you. Come on, somebody. I need Judas in my life. Why is Judas a part of my plan? Why is Judas connected to my destiny? Judas helps me. Come on now. Judas helps me to fulfill my destiny. How do I know? Jesus tells me, I'm done. Amen. Look at verse 27 again. My God, look at verse 27 again. Hallelujah. We're going to be done with this. Verse 27 says this. He said, and after the son of Satan entered into him, then said Jesus unto him. See, Jesus, seeing what is going to happen. Jesus knows what's going to happen. But Jesus had to wait for the right time. Come on. Read it. Amen. Do you see that? Amen. Do you see what it said? He said, after. Come on now.
Yes.
See, there was a process. Amen. Some things have to be completed.
Well.
Notice what he said here. He said, after.
Yes.
Y'all see that?
Yes.
Couldn't happen before.
Right.
Mm-hmm. After the supper. Oh my God. Not only was Jesus waiting, but Satan had to wait. Satan had to wait to suffer with both. Satan was ready to get it. Come on, somebody. But he couldn't get into the last song. Come on, y'all. He said, after the supper, Satan entered into him. And so, Satan had to wait to the last supper. Jesus had to wait till Satan entered into him.
That's right.
So he can say,
that's right, Pastor.
All right, Jesus, you ready now?
Yeah.
All right now.
You ready now?
Huh?
Come on, somebody.
Come on now.
You ready now? So he said, after the supper, Satan entered in. Then, look at the words.
Then.
Hallelujah. Then said Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
Thou dost do it quickly. Come on, somebody. I need you. Because Judas helps to usher in the next level of God in my life. Judas helps me to elevate to the next level of prayer and praise in my life. I need Judas in my life. Because Judas is the world. Come on, somebody. Judas is the one that God uses in my life to get me to the next level.
Yeah.
It is a Judas in your life that'll help lift you up when you can't lift yourself.
Yes,
but God will send a Judas in your life. Oh, my God. Judas helps me to fulfill my destiny. Judas will help me to conquer. Let me give you the summation here. Amen, look at verse 31. This is what it's all about. And it ain't about you.
That's right.
Amen. It ain't about Judas.
That's right.
Look at verse 31. Oh, my God. Oh, I wish I could say it like I feel it. He said, look at verse 31. Therefore, amen. I've been told that whenever you see the word therefore, at the beginning, go back and see what it's there for.
Yeah.
Come on, man. Amen. Go back and read what's way before that. And then you get to the therefore.
Yes.
Come on, hallelujah.
Right now. Come on.
After Jesus has revealed who the betrayer is, after Satan comes into his heart, after he tells Judas to go out and do it quickly, come on, somebody.
Yes.
Then the Bible says, therefore, after all has been completed, all that's been surviving, all that's been done, therefore, when he was going out,
well, yeah.
Jesus said, now, somebody the Son of Man glorified. And God is glorified in him. That was the whole purpose of it. That God be glorified. You need a Judas in your life. That God should be glorified. It ain't about you. It ain't about Judas. It's about him. Oh, glory. That God will be glorified. It's all about him. But I need Judas to get me there. I need a Judas. Come on, somebody. And can I tell you right now? Don't fool yourself. Judas is all—he's not always a male. I've had some female Judas. My God. I'll leave that alone. Well, I had some female Judas as well as some male Judas.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. But that spirit is still alive and well.
Come on,
but you need a Judas in your life. You need somebody to challenge you. You need somebody to provoke you. You need somebody to push you to another level. You need somebody that's going to come against you that will draw you close to the altar again. You're going to need somebody who's going to drive you to the garden of Gethsemane. You're going to need somebody, come on somebody, that will have you on your face before God and to challenge you to get up early in the morning to seek the face of God, to have you to get up at midnight and cry out to God. You need a Judas in your life. Come on, somebody. Come on, stand to your feet and give God a praise. It's not about you. It's about God being pleased. It's not about what you're going through. It's about that God will get the glory. Hallelujah. I need Judas. Oh. Judas, Judas, Judas. Judas will keep you praying. Judas will keep you watching. Judas will keep you discerning.
That's right.
Oh, yeah.
Judas will help you keep your eyes open.
Yeah, Lord.
Hallelujah. 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 Amen. I had a dream one night that there were some snakes in the church. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And there were two small black snakes in a pit. And the enemy was trying to get me to focus on these two small snakes in the pit. But when I began to look over out of the corner of my right eye, I saw the enemy and what the enemy had done. The enemy, as if, because as I was looking at the two small snakes, there was a real big snake on the other side of me. And what the devil did, he took a covering and he covered up the big snake so I couldn't see it. Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. But I saw just enough of it to recognize that he's there.
Yeah. Yeah.
Come on, somebody. Even though he's covered,
come on,
I still know he's there. Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
Even though he's trying to hide, still know he's there. Come on, somebody. And I ain't talking about nobody. Come on, somebody. I ain't calling my name. Hallelujah. But sometimes you got to discern what the devil is trying to cover up. Because this cover up, it still doesn't mean that it's not there. Because this cover up, it doesn't mean that the enemy has stopped working. Because you can't see it, it doesn't mean that it's going away. Because this cover up, that means that you stop looking at it. That means that you ignore it, hoping that it'll go away. But Judas, he ain't going nowhere. Because Judas got an assignment that's ordained of God. And he's going to fulfill his assignment. Hallelujah. I need him. I need Judas. Judas is profitable. Judas is good for me, even though he buffets me. But Judas is good for me. Even though he makes me cry sometimes. But Judas is good for me. I need him. Oh, glory. Come on, give God a praise. So we thank the Lord today. How many of you enjoyed the word? Yeah. Hallelujah. There are some things you just cannot pray away. It is a sign that attached to you. It is a part of your assignment. Hallelujah. Judas is necessary.
Yes, he is.
Some people can't digest that. But if he, like Pastor said, if you have to pray him off, Judas is busy. He's doing what he's supposed to do.
All right.
And he's pushing you and you're drawing closer to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. At this time, we're going to move forward.
Thank you.
If there's anybody, before we partake of the table, if there's anybody that needs special prayer, for any reason, some of you may have encountered your Judas this week.
That's right.
May have been this morning. It can be on your job. As the pastor said, it can be on your job. In your home. It doesn't matter. Make this your hour. Come to the altar. See, if you come to the altar, you leave all that, all of the trials, all of the tests, all of the things that the devil has tried, you leave it at the altar today.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Bring it to the altar with the sense that when I come to the altar, I leave it here. I leave out today with a fresh anointing. Hallelujah. A fresh touch. A new beginning. Hallelujah.
Everybody lift your hand all over the church and bless and give him praise. Start praising him right now. All that he's done, doing, and going through in your life.
There's so much going on.
Come to the altar.